All right, Ragboy here.
And RJ.
And RJ. We're introducing this podcast we're working on for over a year. And the thing is, it has to do with our ballast system. And when we first got the RZ2, when we first reviewed the RZ2, it had just the pro stock ballast system, which was amazing. It was the first time we've ever been in a factory boat that we just filled up the weight on one side and surfed.
Yeah.
And it was amazing. I mean, you were behind it.
Yeah, it was good.
It was a great wake. And I would say it was better than our 24 VE.
Yeah, it was better.
Now, the other thing at Wake 9, though, is we host a lot of pros and we tow competition. So we want to have a competition level wake. And for you 10 percenters out there, that's what this podcast is for, that you can do what you're going to see us do. You're going to get a competition level wake out of the RZ2. And it's amazing. And yet still fully automated. One thing we want to make sure you understand before you watch this video is when you put in these custom sacs, they're designed to be only filled up on one side. The great thing about that, you fill up just one side and you're going to be underweight. So you're not going to be overweighting your boat even with a few people in it. And that's what we want. We want to be riding our boat on a daily basis and it's not overweighted, because that's important. And we don't want people to be out there surfing unsafe. At Wake 9, we want you to wake surf safe and we don't want you overweighting your boats. Almost all of the time when we're out there riding, that rub rail is kissing the water. We don't put the rub rail below the water. All right, RJ?
Yep.
So, anyway, enjoy the podcast. Wake Surf Safe. All right, so Ragboy here. It's September 29th. But what we're here to do today, something we've been waiting for. It's been almost a year. When we first reviewed the RZ2, there was something that we were really excited about, and it's taken this long to get everything done. But at Wake 9, you know that we've always been proponents of wake surf boats that are great for families. There's a lot of boats out there that you can sack out and do a lot of great things with and make killer wakes, but sometimes you end up with sacs on the floor or a weighting system that's difficult to switch from side to side. And so we like that ease of use for family. Just quickly switch, everything is water, it's all hidden, for instance. So we've been hoping that, you know, eventually somebody would come out with a wake surf boat that you could buy from the factory that would pretty much put out a competition wake. And last year Tige contacted us and we discussed the ways we were weighting our Tige, and they put a lot of effort into the new ballast system to really do a good job to make it easy to use and expandable. So here's what we're doing. Currently our Tige has 2,000 pounds of ballast. You have two 400 pound tanks up front, one on each side. They're soft tanks. And then you have a system in the back that has 600 pounds in each side. Now, and here's a picture. I'll show you a picture from when our boat was being built. You can see what it looks like, where you have the in-haul tank, where the arrow is pointing. There's a tank that's underneath the floor of the V-drive locker that holds 250 pounds. And then you see that sack hanging down from the side. That's a custom sack the Tige makes. It holds 350 pounds. All right, so here we are inside of my empty V-drive locker. Now, in the bottom of that hole there, there is, underneath there, is that 250 pound hard tank. Now, that sack that you saw in that picture when my boat was being built is actually behind this screen. Now, the cool thing about this is that you have this sack in here, but it only holds 350 pounds. So it's not very big. Now, the reason Tige does that is simple. One, they don't want to take away all your storage because you might want it. And two, they have to make a boat that won't go over their weight limit. But we only plan, because we're wake surfing, to surf on one side. So that means we only fill one side up at a time. So we can put a bigger sack in here and still stay under the weight limit. So what we're gonna do, and you can see how the sack is not only tied with, you have the fittings going into it for filling and emptying. There's also these anchors that tie to the side of the sack to keep it in place. So here's what we got here. And this is the goofy side sack. What we have here is a custom sack. It's designed to fill up the V-drive locker and go down the side. And if you notice, it's got the anchors and the fittings all in place to slot in to where our stock sack goes. So if all goes well, we should go from 350 pound sack to approximately, this sack probably holds about 12 or 1300 pounds, but we'll probably get about 1,000 pounds in it when it's full. So when we're done, a simple DIY swap, do it yourself swap, and we have a fully automated competition level Wakesurf wake without any modifications other than buying a sack and popping it in. Is that cool? That's cool. All right, let's give it a shot. All right, so we got our resident slave here, RJ, who with just a pair of channel locks, and we've done this before, we've pulled these sacks out, is pulling the sacks out, and he will be replacing the big sack in just a moment. RJ, do you like playing with your sack? Okay, it's only been about 5 or 6 minutes, and RJ has completely removed the old 350 pound sack, as you see here. All right, so RJ has installed the sack and they're anchored to the side. And we're really hoping with that anchor, one of the problems with a big custom sack is sometimes they twist and turn and it makes it difficult to fill. So we're hoping it's gonna work very well. Okay, so we're gonna fill this up. So Maddie, go to the ballast. Maddie, go ahead and hit fill on that, right, hit it. There we go. Okay, so we're gonna see how long it takes to fill up this bad boy. Okay, as you can see, we probably could have made the sack a little bit taller. This is what it took, 1332 to fill. Starting to come out the vent now. Well, now, let's surf.
Hey everyone, RJ here. I just want to take a quick second and talk about the wave after we got those sacks installed. The wave was very nice, it was long and big and had a lot of push, and later in the video you will see Dennis Horton riding switch on the regular side, and the wave has so much push that it is able to push Dennis Horton back to the front of the wave from all the way in the back without him even pumping. With that said, enjoy the rest of the video.
Alright, it's Friday during the day now, no more nighttime filming, so we're going to have some good footage today, and we're going to test out those sacks and check out the wake and see how these custom sacks are working. We installed the goofy side a few minutes ago, just as easy as the regular, and ready to go, filled up in about 15 minutes, so we're ready to go. And we got Chris Majestic from Wake World of Tige Owners. Go ahead and shoot over to Chris. Chris will be one of our guinea pigs today. So Chris is a good friend of Wake 9, so we're going to have some fun today.
Wake. It's got a lot of push and it's effortless. You can just move your feet and it's hard to fall out the back.